You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance After Show.
There it is.
I love that intro music so much. It makes me feel like I'm back home.
It makes me want to back that thing up.
Back home covering So You Think You Can Dance? Season 9. What episode is this? 10? We're in the eliminations again. We're at the top 14.
Yeah.
The Olympics are over. We're back. Bing is for doing it. We're doing it big tonight. We've got a big guest in the studio. First off, I've got my lovely co-host. I'm your host, AJ Gibson, obviously. But my lovely co-host, Corrine Williams, is back. And we've got Courtney Galiano from Seasons 4 and Season 7 All-Stars.
Yeah, and she's cute as a button.
She is.
Thanks, guys.
Cuter than a button. And she's got a deep voice, apparently.
Yeah.
So she's our little expert in-house tonight. Kristen is out. Kristen's actually going to be gone the next couple of weeks.
Oh,
she's working, though, so
get your money,
we are proud of Kristen, so we miss you. Yeah, we'll see you in a couple of weeks, Kristen. But big episode tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting episode. We've been on a hiatus for a couple of weeks watching the Olympics. I hope you all enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But I missed you. But tonight we've got, it's me and Michael's night.
Yes.
What they did is they decided to bring back me and Michael's most well-known pieces that have been nominated for awards and whatnot over the course of these seasons, and the entire show is about her. Which is kind of interesting. I wasn't sure. We were all kind of tentative about this at the beginning because there's a lot of big performances that we all are ingrained in our brains that it's hard for these dancers to live up to these performances.
Mm-hmm.
Some did better than others, but it was a neat idea, I think.
I think so. I just want to point out that the first three were from season 4 and my closest friends. I'm just saying.
You guys,
I'm doing this. Like I
was that your season? That was your season.
Yeah, was
Twitch,
my
did
season.
Twitch start that?
Josh won Twitch and Comfort.
Twitch, Comfort, yeah. And it just stopped.
Because they were the last ones left, so they were like,
Comfort. I love Comfort. We had her in the
gosh,
studio a few weeks
she's
ago.
She's amazing. Hi, Comfort.
Yeah, hi, Comfort. And more importantly, hi, Comfort's mom. I love her mom. She's
her
adorable.
The best.
She's so cool. So cool.
Yeah.
But then also tonight, we had some guest judges on the panels. We had the Royal Ballet's Michael, Nunn, and Billy Trevitt. They're known as the Ballet Boyz.
BBs.
Yeah.
I actually thought it was kind of cool that they had them judge because, honestly, they never really watched any of the dances. So
exactly.
It was actually kind of cool to have the differences up there where, you know, Mary and Nigel totally have seen these dances over and over again.
Mary and Nigel, I think, like most viewers, ourselves included, they have these memories of these dances, like the bench dance and the drug dance, the cancer dance, how you all refer to them now over, you know.
The door dance.
The door, all these iconic images in our brains from So You Think You Can Dance all these seasons, and it was nice to have half the panel who's never seen any of these before.
Yeah,
I thought
sure.
It was an interesting. I thought
that
it was cool.
Genius.
Yeah, because those are tough shoes to fill.
Yeah, and I like their perspective though because they just came from they're technically trained ballet dancers, so you know the eye is completely different in what it is that they're seeing.
Yeah, I was really nervous at first. I kind of watching was like, oh my gosh, how are they gonna fill these shoes? And I don't know. I think the opening, oh my gosh. Let's
Sick
get to the
knee.
Opening.
The opening was fantastic.
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
It was so like Cirque du Soleil. It was artistic. It was athletic.
Yes.
I think it was very different.
Yeah.
I think the use of props was awesome. I think
it showed that Mia Michael still has it.
Absolutely.
And everybody else is still chasing her because I felt like earlier in the season we were a little bit I've been a little bit let down by her so far this season just because I feel like here's the thing. She's a phenomenal photographer. She's a phenomenal photographer. Phenomenal choreographer. But when you set the bar that high, it makes it so difficult for you. Everyone else is trying to, catch her,
Yeah.
other other choreographers have their moments, but nobody's as consistent, I don't think, as Mia Michaels. And nobody's been nominated for as many awards as Mia Michaels, in the context of this show at least. Yeah. And so she's not competing with anyone else but herself. And that's difficult. I think this number, though, oh my, she nailed it.
Yeah,
she
killed it. I thought it was pretty unbelievable. And in response to that comment, yeah, I think when you're competing against yourself, sometimes it's even harder than competing against other people because, you know, if you really look at it from the other side, how she's very committed to the things that she puts out there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so sometimes it's, you're more creative than other times. And you know what the thing is, whether it's the best she's done or not, I feel that she really tries hard to be the best that she can be all the time.
Yes, and none of her numbers are ever cookie cutter.
Yeah.
They're always all so different. Unique and so powerful in their own way. And they're not always exactly the same style. We saw a pretty wide variety of styles tonight, and they were all Mia Michaels.
Yes,
whereas some choreographers, I mean, you can definitely tell, oh, that's so-and-so or that's so-and-so. And Mia Michaels, don't get me wrong, she puts her touch on her choreography every time.
She always keeps who she is in there somewhere.
But she's got some range.
Oh,
and
totally.
This show, and especially this opening number, I mean, they were aerial artists. It did look very Cirque du Soleil, I thought. Mm-hmm. At first, the first 10, 15 seconds of the number, I was like, I kind of was resisting it a little bit. Because I was like, this is kind of strange. But then I kind of got entranced by it all. And like, the camera angles, the lighting, everything was...
I was just going to say, it was shot so
beautifully.
Well.
Yeah.
But she's trying to get into that. She's trying to get into directing. And I feel she's very good at it.
Mm-hmm.
I think she's...
I like her.
Yeah.
I think she needs to get into a hair salon.
Oh, my God.
On her way to the director's chair.
No, sure.
Her hair is so weird this year. I don't get it, though. I don't get it. She's so talented and so absurdly amazing. I shouldn't care about something like that. But I'm like, it looks like weird. Like, you know how people used to get highlights and they pull their hair through a cap?
Yeah.
That's what it looks like to me.
But
I don't get it.
She doesn't care. She's so creative that she's like, this is it. This is trending right now.
Yeah.
The mere fact that we're sitting here talking about it
about her hair
is trending right now.
Because
she's like, I don't care. I'm a genius.
I used to get my hair pulled through a cap. Did you know that?
I'm glad you stopped. Because that's just not hot.
Anyways, another little bit of good news. They opened the show with a picture of Nappy Tab's baby, London Riley.
Oh, my God.
So congratulations to two of my favorite choreographers. I think they're genius.
Yes.
And their numbers are just fun.
They're so fun.
Not lately, though.
Well,
I haven't been loving their numbers lately.
I feel like when you're expecting a baby any day and you're choreographing three or four numbers per episode, that's a tall order. And I think their choreography has been a little bit generic lately. But, you know, something like having a child, their first child, I believe. Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, that can inspire something new.
Well,
you know?
Let's hope.
Yeah.
And that's why you have assistants to help you when you choreograph.
They have a lot of assistants. And
yeah.
They have a lot of assistants.
So don't blame the baby on these lackluster performances.
I don't know. I think I personally feel like Nappy Tabs really does. They're another one. They leave it on the floor, and they're really dedicated to the work that they put out there. And I also feel like they're another choreographer that kind of compete against themselves as well.
But not these past routines that they've put together for the people on the show.
See, I disagree. I thought the one with Tiffany and George, the
Rugrats looking one.
See, but I think that was inspired. I did. I thought it was awesome.
We were so bored by that.
Because of the colors?
No, I think it was just like really fun, and it was like hard hitting, and I really liked it. And I really liked the week before that, the one with Amelia and Will, the dumpster one.
I did enjoy that one.
I thought it was very quirky, and I actually think it showed their range of choreography, because you know, as a choreographer on that show, you have to also give the dancers things that complement the dancers,
right.
Because then the judges are going to sit up there and smash the choreography.
And that is part of it for sure, because I don't feel like they don't have a twitch or a comfort or some of these really strong street or hip hop dancers this season. There aren't a lot of
contemporary
them.
Contemporary dancers who are doing hip hop.
Yeah. They have Cyrus the Shaker.
But he's different though.
He's just a shaker.
Exactly.
But they put him in a hip hop category.
They do.
And I don't really consider him hip hop.
And he is no twitch. He just isn't.
He's no twitch.
I really enjoy Cyrus. He's just not Twitch.
Yeah.
Did Nappy Tabs do the ballerina number in the music box? Did they do that one with Eliana? I did enjoy that one.
With Cyrus and Eliana.
Awesome. I did enjoy that one.
I thought that was awesome.
I did like that one.
We'll cut you guys some slack.
I like
enjoy
that one.
The new baby.
Yeah.
The baby's beautiful. Oh, I love babies. So, our first official number of the night, as far as the competition goes, the door number. All right. Now, this was made kind of iconic, again, by Twitch and Katie. In season, was it your season?
Four.
Season four. The first few are all season four. Tonight, Cyrus and Eliana got to take this number on. I guess I could see why they would pick them. It makes sense that if you're going to compare Cyrus to somebody, it's going to be Twitch, I guess.
No, not you guess. That's all wrong.
But if there's anybody on the show who's going to be compared to Twitch, it would have to be Cyrus, obviously. There's nobody else this season that's kind of a street performer male like that.
Mary called it swaggerocious.
Swaggerocious. I said I feel like she's been hanging out with Lil C lately. They're trying to come up with some cool lingo to use. No,
he
Mary.
He always makes up a word. He's like, oh, I'm going to say light atrocious tonight. Yeah. That means fire.
Swaggerocious. That will, not catch on.
I always liked when he judged.
Did you?
Yeah, because I feel like he actually really paid attention and gave each person really the critique that they needed.
But what about these words he used to make up?
I'm all about it. No. I feel like it's great. Yeah, that's like saying, do you know the book by Judy Blume where like that kid tried to make the pen the name Frindle and they wouldn't make, oh sorry, I'm swaying. I'm a swayer.
I'm swaying.
Swayerbocious.
Or it's like the movie Mean Girls. They try to get Fence to catch on.
Yeah, but it's like, it's whatever. And I feel like I enjoyed dancing for him because I feel like I got a critique back. I got a really educated...
with those made up words.
Even with the makeup made up words.
Okay. Possibly because he's not a regular judge. He's only there a couple times a season.
Yeah, that's
so
true
he took advantage of this. I mean, you're Nigel Lithgow and you're watching every single performance the entire season.
I agreed with Nigel a lot.
Oh, me too. Yeah. I wrote down a lot of what he said.
Yes, well, I thought Cyrus had a moment in this. I thought when he was up against the door, kind of shaking, that was cool.
Yeah, that was very cool.
I really enjoyed that.
I liked that too.
I think that Eliana, as much as I love her, she definitely didn't live up to Katie.
I think she was but she's also a ballet dancer. Yes. Very, very, very technical. So that I think that is asking, sometimes when you watch ballerinas, there's not a lot going on up top.
Yes.
Yeah. But you look at their lines and you look at their feet and their arms and their extensions and their portabras coming from their back and you're like, oh my gosh.
What kind of dancer was Katie?
Katie was a contemporary dancer, but Katie is really wonderful. Yeah, like she
dances.
Yeah,
great.
From like a deeper place. Like she's an incredible dancer. Mm-hmm. And when she did that number, you watched it and you just felt it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Didn't Katie make her season with her friend, the redhead?
Natalie, and she didn't.
Natalie did not make it.
Oh, that's right. They cut her at the end or something, right?
It was before the end that they cut her. Remember, she got sent home like Vegas.
Did she make it through the next season?
She made it to Green Mile. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, I remember that. They said she didn't want it bad enough.
No, but then she came back, didn't she, though?
She came back.
And then that's when they cut her in Vegas.
Yes. I remember that. She was on a couple of seasons.
Yeah. Well, I commend her for coming back. Yeah, she's a phenomenal dancer.
Amber came back year after year after year, and they cut her ass last week. I don't even talk about that. I'm still upset about it. Amber, we love you. Next couple we've got, George and Tiffany.
I love George.
They were doing, the number, another
Hometown Glory.
Another one from season four, Joshua and Katie.
Yep.
Hometown Glory, which was it?
Oof, Hometown Glory. It was with Josh and Katie. It was season four.
What was the premise, though? I can't remember. What did it look like?
Wasn't he coming back for, it was.
The assisted run.
They were all in the black.
Yeah.
Yes. What did you guys think about this number?
Loved it.
What do you think about the number tonight?
I thought it was fantastic.
I loved it.
I did, too. I think you said it best when we were watching it. It was like this reckless abandonment.
Yeah.
And I was definitely impressed. I think it showed strength. I think it was beautiful. I know Nigel said something that I would rather say calm down than to say I need more from you.
Mm-hmm.
And I 100,000,000% agree with that.
I think that in general, these dancers have to remember they're not just on stage.
No,
they're on camera in front of millions of people. And it's the same as a host.
Yes.
I've been told that it's so much easier to say, bring it down just a little bit.
Absolutely.
As opposed to like, bring your energy up.
Yeah. Because,
you know? And Nigel, again, he gave a good critique on that. I think that Tiffany just threw herself into this, physically and metaphorically. She threw herself into this routine, and I really, really, I really appreciated that. George, for me, I'm just bored out of my mind by him.
Why? I don't know. Fight you about this.
Do you know? You know how sometimes you watch, like you watch a film and or you see a great actor, and for some reason, for me, Russell Crowe, most boring actor on the planet. For me, I have no idea why. I don't have a reason. I love his films. I think he's the most boring actor ever, and some people love him. I don't know why. I just don't respond to him. I don't respond to George. I think George seems like probably a sweetheart. He's a phenomenal technician. I am so bored by him.
I think it's because we never really saw a story created around him for you.
But do you see how much the stories like count?
They do, yeah, for they sure. Do,
because you have to be able to relate or connect. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you may not have been able to relate to George, but the person at home watching could be like, God, you know, something he said, they might register with him.
Absolutely.
And all of a sudden, that's their
And
favorite.
I think the little mustache has Don't got you. To go. George, shave that Aww, thing.
George.
I will shave it for you.
Leave him alone.
I feel like I have some, like, crazy emotional connection to all of them because I saw them, like, since the beginning.
Oh, yeah.
You helped them with their choreo.
Explain that a bit to our listeners.
Okay, so before they get in front of the judges, they have to get in front of Jeff Thacker, who, I mean, he is behind the camera, but he's the man that is literally, without him, that show would not run. He's the co-executive producer, and he is unbelievable. And so before we go to the judges, what he does is there are prelims. He sits and sees every single dancer in every single city freestyle.
Wow.
And so me and Robert Roldan from season 7 got the chance to do that. And we saw every...
With Jeff?
Yep. Okay. And we saw every single dancer and got to, talk to them and got to see what they were, see what they were made of. And I really enjoyed it. I really, really enjoyed it. But I knew exactly what all of them were feeling. Mm-hmm. And so that's why, like, I'm always going to be, like, the dancer's cheerleader. When you guys are like, well, I'm like,
That's why you're team George.
Yeah.
George has soul when he dances.
I'm with you.
Yeah. I don't see it, and I don't know why. Maybe it is because they didn't spend a lot of time on it in Vegas. I mean, that's the same with anything with the Olympics. I mean, why do we care about some random, like, canoer from, Des Moines? It's because we see their package and see their backstory, and it's the same
and
thing.
That's what you could, and that's what you cling to. That's what you relate to.
Yeah. That's why I was pulling for Amber. 4 seasons it took her to get on the show, and she's gone.
No.
Again, how many times can I bring her up?
Don't try to act like she's your friend when you were talking about her hair and everything else.
No.
You were not going for the sister.
Let's just be very clear.
Let's be honest.
Let's be very clear.
I was rooting for her.
She and Brandon sold that last routine. Oh, that's the one I was talking about. That's what frustrates me about the new format, is you don't get a vote that day. They killed it that night, and we didn't get to vote for them that night because they both got sent home. That's frustrating.
Right.
Her hair, the first 3 times she auditioned was a oh my God, it was a tragic mess.
She was sweating.
But this season, she brought it. I'm happy for her.
With her hair.
Moving on to the next routine, which I simply referred to as the butt.
Oh, yeah.
This is, originally it was Evan and Randy who did this number, which is one of my favorites all time.
And it was fantastic.
It was. Yeah. And tonight, Will and Amelia took it on. Mm-hmm. This one, of any of the routines, made the most sense to me. That they would give, especially for Amelia.
Amelia, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it just seems like...
She seems like she was in her element for sure.
She totally was.
And she looked like it, too. Yeah. That hair.
That era.
And that, yeah.
It was just tailor-made for her.
Absolutely.
We all really liked it. I said that she may have danced equally to Randy.
Totally.
I think that Will... I don't know. Evan was such a unique character.
Yeah.
Especially in the history of everything you dance, he's just unique. He's not one of the best dancers. He's just unique.
Yeah.
So I think that Will had a hard time keeping up with that, especially with Amelia. Whether she's a great technician or not, she steals your eye.
Yes.
And
I do feel like Will, though, like, Evan was totally a character, and I loved Evan. I loved him. But I feel like, so think about, like, a goofy dude, right? All, when they, like, see a chick and can't contain themselves. Right. Like, they get, like, all giddy and
goofy.
Things like that. And I, when I look at Will, he is, like, he's...
Apparently, Phil's also...
he's, like, the Thanks, sweetest, bro. Like, goofy, like, very endearing kid. And I And so I do feel like he portrayed that tonight. So it may not have been what Evan was, but I think he brought something different to it.
I said that I didn't love it or hate it. It was just a number that was easy to watch for me. Yeah. But some things that I thought was interesting were Nigel's comments when he was talking about Amelia and was like, oh, well, you know, her first negative critique throughout her time on the show, telling her that she was looking down at the floor too much.
She did not like that.
She
You said it also. You said that you need to take critiques with class and dignity, essentially.
Yeah, you have to take it with grace. Yeah. Because at the end of the day, they don't want to hurt you. Yeah. You know what I mean? They want to...
And it won't get you votes.
No.
When you have an attitude.
Yeah, and you have to be able, especially in this industry where, like, all you are is ever judged, mm-hmm. you need to take it very gracefully. And even if you don't agree with what they say, you take it and you do with it what you want. Yeah. You can either take that criticism or you could be like, all right, thank you so much for that, but no thanks.
Correct me if I'm wrong, though, but the life of a dancer, I mean, and I know it's brutal. I have a lot of friends who are dancers out here. And there's no such thing as perfection.
No.
And no matter what you do, no matter what part of a routine or a number that you perfect, mm-hmm. whatever, get the choreography down, there's always room for improvement somewhere else.
Yeah.
So you have to be able to take constructive criticism, and that's all it really is.
That's just like real life.
She did not take it well. She just looked mad. And I feel like she's the type of person, and I think I was told this by a friend or I read this somewhere, so I won't say. But I hear that she's kind of, she kind of is the type who kind of just does her own thing. She's a little bit of a loner, and you can tell that from.
Herself.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that it came across as she's the type of girl who's probably always been the unique one wherever she was, whatever dance studio she was in, and whatever town she grew up in. And now, for the first time, she's getting critiqued as not being the star. Because these kids are all stars where they come from.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You know?
It's a humbling experience when you come together with such incredible talent in one room.
And she is talented and she is unique. She does have a career in front of her. And I think that she's very memorable. Mm-hmm. Even though, like, we see later that she gets sent home tonight. But for top 14, she's probably one of the most memorable people ever voted off at top 14.
And she was one of the best.
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest.
Yeah, she was great. Yeah. She's had a couple of really memorable numbers. The dumpster number.
Yeah.
And then the one in the black and the white suits. I thought Will was a little rough in that one, but I thought she was great in that number.
She carried him.
I was a little surprised.
Yeah.
We'll get to that part later,
but she's
though.
Young, you know, so hopefully she will learn from this experience just really grow.
Absolutely. And the good thing about this show is that somebody watching
really
loves you. And when you walk into a room, they could say, oh, my gosh, that's that girl that did that. And I loved that.
Mm-hmm.
And you're hired. You know what I mean? So I believe she did make her mark, and she will be remembered for that.
It just breaks my heart that this is that episode. There's a few standout episodes per season, and this one, we talked about this, and you can explain this a little more, but they're competing to go on tour.
Absolutely.
And that's a big deal, especially for these dancers who never toured before, most of them, I'm sure. What kind of pressure does that add
Oh, my gosh. I remember. I remember sitting there being like, all I wanted. The funny thing is, I don't think any of us on my season ever focused on winning. It was like, Jesus, dear Lord, please just get me through this day. You know?
Really?
And yeah, like I don't think there was ever a time except the top four. I remember sitting there going like, geez Louise, I'm here. Like, that's kind of crazy, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
But I remember the tour episode where if we made it, we were going to 46 different cities, performing in arenas. I was going to get to go to my hometown and perform where I went and saw concerts and I went and saw artists. Like, how insane is that? You know, I remember season 7, like, I danced in a sold-out Radio City Music Hall.
Yeah.
Like, that's insane. So I remember really wanting to experience that.
And you're young dancers and you're getting paid.
Oh, my gosh. Exactly. And this is the thing. I don't know of a show that you go to that is just about the dancers and you're playing yourself. Mm. You are not an actor. You're not behind an artist. You are playing yourself and people are in the audience, like, with signs that say, go George, go Amelia,
go Courtney,
go, like, Twitch. It was the most surreal thing in the whole world. And I would have been very upset if I didn't get to experience that. So this is a tough episode. This
so now
is
I'm
going to
start crying because I feel good. So bad for these kids. Yeah,
it is. Don't it's cry. It's a tough episode. Well,
but it's sure the business.
It is the business.
So this is a great battlegrounding learning zone for them
and
to
I thought
build
Nigel,
their muscle.
Absolutely. And I thought Nigel brought up another good point saying, well, usually the choreographers do cater to the dancers. Now, this is something where this may not be what was choreographed for them. But, I mean, I've done millions of jobs where, like, yeah, I do things that are definitely not choreographed for the dancer that I am.
You go on tour with an artist, right, or you step in on a Broadway
show.
You have to be a chameleon.
Yes, you have to adapt.
Bob Fosse choreographed this number 50, 40 years,
absolutely,
who knows, and you have to just step in and do
absolutely
it.
Absolutely. So it was good training, but I definitely was not sure if I was going to like it in the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah, it started growing. I think also the first few numbers, these first few, didn't really stand out for me. Mm-hmm. They were okay. They weren't bad. I think they got better as the episode progressed. There's some good ones coming up later.
Yeah.
I want to know what you guys think, though. We're partially through this. We've got the first few dances down. We want to know what you guys think. Get on iTunes, rate, comment, tell your friends about us. Let us know what your favorite dance of tonight or of the season has been. If you guys comment on there, I will get on there and I will respond to you. So will Corrine, and if she doesn't, I will make her. Corrine, girl, get your life. No, but it really helps us out. And if you guys can rate us, give us good ratings, and like I said, tell your friends about us. That's how we keep doing what we do. And if there's another guest, we've got great guests so far this season. We've had Comfort, we have Courtney, we've got Lauren Gottlieb coming in a couple of weeks. She's one of my favorites. I'm actually, mm-hmm, she's a friend of mine. I love her to death. We've got some other guests that we're working on that we can't tell you just yet, but we want to know who you guys want to see in here. So if you guys want to go on iTunes and let us know, we'll take your advice and do the best that we can to get your favorite past dancers
That's
in the studio.
So nice, AJ.
Yeah,
That's
I do what
nice.
I do.
You do it well.
You know, I had two weeks off. Well, I love the Olympics, but I really miss the show and I miss AfterBuzz.
Do you think dance should be an Olympic sport?
I think it kind of is. Did you watch the gymnastics ones with the ribbons
and
the balls?
Oh my gosh,
like,
I know.
I didn't know. What is that?
I was tired for them.
I know. I was
flipping
exhausted.
Flipping and catching and spinning. Oh.
Eastern Europeans, they got on lockdown. I didn't see an American girl anywhere. Said, Gabby Douglas wasn't throwing no ribbons. Uh-oh.
No, you saw the American girl who didn't do well at all. And she said she's moving to LA to become an actress.
Well, there you go.
And she didn't play. She got no medal.
That's what you do when you don't medal at the Olympics.
Yeah.
You move to LA.
You move to LA and get on a reality show.
Yeah, and let your dreams fall apart slowly. So our next dance.
But she went to the Olympics nonetheless.
Girl, she's an Olympian. She got her life. Our next number of the night is simply referred to by me as the bed routine.
Yes.
This was originally done by Twitch and Carrington. Again,
Twitch is so hot. Hi, Twitch.
Twitch shirtless. Twitch, if you're watching or listening, Twitch shirtless is a sight to behold.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm a fan.
He's like my brother.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
they're like,
well, you think he's hot?
You send him my love. But this, Darian and Janelle have the task, the tall, tall task of taking this number on tonight.
Yes, they did.
I thought they did a nice job. I thought that Janelle lacked a little bit. I love her, and she was my early on favorite. I think she's stunning.
Yeah,
one of the prettiest
so
girls probably in the
she's
history
gorgeous.
Of the show.
Yeah.
Next to season 4 had a girl, Courtney, I believe her name was. She was a hottie.
No, but
I think Janelle is just stunning, and she's unique. I really, really wanted to see her do a Bollywood number, because for whatever reason in my head, I'm like, oh, it's similar, right? I don't know if it is at all, but I feel like at least the costumes are close.
You only say that because of her last performance.
Her costume.
Yeah. When
she looked like a Bollywood dancer.
Shake it.
But Darian, for me, he really stole this number.
He did.
That number, I don't know how you described it, where he did like a kick twist, land on the bed thing.
Oh, I said the kick flip.
The kick flip. Unreal.
I thought it was so good.
And he landed so precisely. And it's interesting to me because I don't know a lot about dance, but I know what I respond to. It's kind of like art for me. I don't know a lot about art, but I know what I enjoy.
Right.
The way that he did it with such precision, at the same time, again, that reckless abandon, but they came together just perfectly. It didn't look... like you say, a lot of times, like ballet dancers, they're mm-hmm. so blank, but they're precise.
Yes.
He had the precision.
Yes.
But he wasn't blank.
No, he definitely had emotion behind it. And I think that's what, you know, whenever I'm teaching, I always say to the kids, you know, you really have to use dynamic. You have to give the highs and the lows and the hards and the slows and the fasts and the softs. And you have to kind of tell your story using that, because we don't speak when we dance.
So basically you're saying it's like sex. Is that what you're saying? The high, the low, the fast, the slow. I don't know.
I don't know
where you're going with this.
No. But it has to, it definitely has to appeal to the eye. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You have to, like, when you're sitting there, you're like, or, oh my gosh, or, ooh, yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
it can't be level the entire time.
No, mm-hmm. No. I always say when there's a reason why when you die, it goes beep.
Takes you on a ride.
It's just one level the whole time.
You know life's not like that.
No, it is not. It is up and down. Just like that little machine.
It's hard, slow, fast.
That's
slow.
Get it, girl.
Irritating. Yeah,
irritating, annoying.
Slow down, a rash. I don't
know.
She needs some ointment.
But listen, what I really liked about this particular routine, I wrote in my notes, I said, wow, this is, you know, much credit to Mia Michaels.
Absolutely.
And why she's, you know, so well regarded within the show is because though Twitch, you know, did it, and of course everyone remembers Twitch,
right,
this was almost like a brand new routine with
Absolutely.
These two.
I agree with you,
you know, 100%. Though, yeah, they're you know, she's renowned for the bed routine, and you know, everyone's like, oh, Twitch was so amazing, but I was like, wow, this is almost like I'm watching a brand new routine. And that's what she did with a few other you know, of the
numbers. And I feel these dancers later in the show really started to sell the routines a lot better.
Oh, definitely.
They just continually got better, I felt like.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think Darian really made it his own.
Yeah.
And I just loved watching him.
And you know,
what his feet looked like.
You know what else I enjoyed?
I didn't even notice your feet, Darian.
Yeah, I just thought he was so good.
Yeah, they did critique his feet just a little bit.
Yeah.
But I thought that it was really interesting that they both ended up going home, didn't they? But I thought that in this number, at least, I thought that it'd be very easily to do a number like the bed routine with a girl like Janelle, who's just smoldering sex appeal.
Yeah, Carrington was too. Jeez,
yes,
Louise.
Yes. But Darian, but Twitch, man, like Twitch, he was still in control of that bed. He's a man.
Right.
Darian kind of is boyish. And I thought he than
he
held his own with Janelle.
It.
I
that's
thought
a,
he became
a
man in that number. And I was like, Janelle did not eat him up like I thought she would.
Yeah.
You know, because she's definitely not a Twitch. Twitch, just his stature alone and his confidence is just, he's Twitch.
Right.
And Darian, I literally felt like I saw him become a man in that number.
But that's the same you can say for Whitney. Like, when I see her just before she dances, she's just cute. Like, little 18-year-old Whitney, right?
Dances,
and then she dances. Geez. I'm like, who was this hot woman, like, standing in front of me, like, seducing the world with her eyes and her body? You know?
The first time we saw her, I was like, what? Like, we all lost our minds. Like,
double take,
lost
right?
our minds.
Yeah.
Well, no, because she's, it's exactly what you say. When you watch her, she's this, like, woman, like, this smoldering hot woman. And then she's like, hi, Winnie. You know what I mean? Like, she's this, like, little girl. She's an unbelievable dancer.
Yeah, I'm impressed with a couple of ballroom dancers that I feel are going to end up on Dance with the Stars in a couple of seasons.
Yeah.
There's only two, so.
Well, I feel like they could both be there.
Lindsay and Whitney.
Julianne Hough's been gone for a while. Chelsea Hightower can't carry that blonde ambition tour forever. I feel like a couple of them could end up there someday. They're fierce.
Yeah.
Lacey's there.
They're all wonderful.
Lacey is there, but she's not ballroom anymore.
Lacey?
Yeah.
She's on Dance with the Stars.
I know, but I feel like all her routines are not, like, they're just, like,
they're like
more,
yeah.
like, pop and...
I mean, let's give her the gay dude. What's up with that?
No,
I know Lacey
don't.
Cool. Yeah, they do. What are you talking about? Next routine
Anyways,
of the night.
Get your life.
This is the cancer routine, correct?
The
flowers?
Time.
This is Audrey and Matt. This was when... one about
flowers.
Mia's father. About meeting somebody that... Again, after they've passed.
This wasn't the cancer routine. I was thinking of a different one. She did lose her father, though, and that's what this routine was about.
Yeah, time.
This one was sad.
It was sad.
And I feel like this is where, like, with the starting with the bed, I think this is where the routines really picked up.
Yeah.
And I thought that this one was just, I thought it was beautiful. They said that this was originally done, like you said, by Neil and Lacey, but they said that in this one, Matthew, aka Ryan Gosling. The Notebook. He lacked passion and truth, and I kind of saw that.
Totally.
I thought that Audrey danced her face off.
Oh my gosh.
I think
she's
that she
stunning.
Was just incredible. Matthew was just a little bit dead in the face.
Yeah, he, to me, and I wrote this before the judges even gave the critique while he was dancing, I just said, wow, I don't know who you are, Matthew, like, at all. And for Audrey, I was like, she's a shining star. And before this, I never really paid attention to her, mm-hmm. like, at all.
And Matthew, the thing is, this is what were we on, episode 10? 10. And we're still calling Matthew Ryan Gosling. I still have to ask what his name is every time.
See, I don't know you.
He's just a little bit forgettable. He's a really good-looking guy. He's obviously a great dancer just to even be on the show. Yeah. But
he'll be fine.
Yeah.
He'll be fine in the industry.
Yeah.
He'll be good.
Well, he's good-looking, and he's got good
technique.
He's adorable,
and he's talented, and he has technique. And mm-hmm. And I think I don't know what the choreographers think of him, but mm-hmm. I feel like it was a lot of technique.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like Audrey got it.
Mm-hmm.
And when she turned in the beginning and just stopped, it was like one of those moments that you were like,
mm-hmm.
like it, she nailed it to me.
It's interesting how a dancer, how she can still create moments in a dance that we've mm-hmm. all seen so many times.
Right. Yeah.
And if you're a fan of the show, you watch these things on YouTube over and over again. Right. I've got a boring day or it's cold and rainy outside and I watch it, so you think you can dance videos.
That's
I just
awesome.
Do.
Are they recorded on your DVR?
Awesome. The one, Ramalama Ding Dong, that
oh
number.
My gosh,
I've watched that 1,000
so
times.
I know.
But it's interesting that it's really a testament to Audrey's skills to be able to take a number like this and to create moments that are memorable that maybe for a moment make you not think of Lacey.
Mm-hmm.
Because I love, love, love Lacey. And there were moments where I was like, ooh, Audrey, you brought something new to the
right.
table. That's interesting.
And I think that's what tonight was about.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what tonight was about was to, you know, because these are some of like, some of the best routines that ever hit the
they are.
Stage. Mm-hmm. And I feel like we said in the beginning, it was a lot for them.
And in years past, they've done the all-star thing where they brought back a new partner with, you've been a part of this, where new contestants partner with old contestants mm-hmm. or whatnot, and they switch it up. And that's great, and it's interesting, and I think it's nice to see them try to hold their own with these veterans, which is cool. But it's really interesting to see the two rookies take on these veteran pieces without having somebody there to kind of like pull them through the routine.
Right.
They both have to figure out a way to work together, to partner together to make it their own.
Right.
And I think that's a challenge. I think some people lived up to it and some people didn't,
yeah.
but that was to be expected.
I do love this dance. I love like what it's about.
I thought that Nigel, though, his critique was a little bit awkward. I felt like he really put them on the spot.
He was a little bit harsh, right? He was, I feel like.
Because he was asking him, he's like, what was this number about? What did it mean to her father? What or to my me? And I'm just like, I get it. But I feel like that's a conversation you have when the cameras aren't on you and you're live in front of millions of people or whatever.
I think he was trying to drive the point home, though. Like, dancing is more than just having great lines and being, like, 100%. This wonderful technique. It's about the story, the emotion that you need to be able to sell or convey to those who are watching.
I get that. I just felt bad for Matthew because Nigel knew Matthew was going home when he was saying those
words. Well, we knew when Nigel said it to Matthew.
Yes.
Bye.
Yeah, and I feel like that's a conversation that he could have had more impact on Matthew privately having that conversation with him as opposed to – I felt like he kind of embarrassed him a little bit on national TV, and Nigel usually doesn't do that.
He embarrassed both of them, in my opinion,
because
they
both were fumbling.
But you need to know what you're dancing about.
Do you need to know it, though, on national television?
You should know what you're – like
– It's your job, right?
Well, not even that it's your job. It's like that's what the dance is. Like, so mm-hmm. you should know – You should know that. And if you don't know that, then maybe say, well, I don't know this, but this is what I was thinking,
what I felt,
mm-hmm. what she said. So you have to, I think that's important to show commitment to your piece. My dance teacher always said that. You have to have commitment to your piece. Nobody wants to watch BS.
Yeah, looking at it holistically, like it seemed unfair a little bit.
I don't know. I've been committed to my piece my entire life. I don't think that I feel
Shut
like
up.
What? I got some jokes tonight. No, I feel like though, Matthew, though, I just felt like it was like one comment too far. Just a hair, like kind of pushing the envelope a little bit, and I'm just maybe because I'm not used to seeing Nigel comment that way.
Oh, he's been rude a few times.
Yeah, but I feel like he's usually dead on. And I feel like he was dead on. I think it was fair. I just felt like this number was such an emotional number anyways. I felt like if I were Matthew, I would have taken it like this. I just completely just did not respect Mia's father and I just let her down.
You're
and
not going to say that.
I would feel so bad though if I'm hearing that. That's how I would take it. So I just felt bad for Matthew. I think he's a nice guy. I don't think he's the best dancer.
Well, yeah. I mean, the Ballet Boyz, they said to him that he needed to find a way to disguise the effort. So, like, when he was preparing to, like, do the lifts and everything else he was doing.
They said he came in and out of it a lot.
Yeah.
And when something, they said it doesn't matter if there's, you know, you're about to trip on something on the stage or if something's going wrong, you can't let us see that. And, I mean,
it just wasn't his night.
I get it. I just feel bad for the guy. Mm. I've got a heart. What can I say?
But he'll be fine.
I understand.
Huh, Courtney?
Yeah.
He'll be
dancing
good.
Right now.
He'll
he's
be good.
Just signed a dance
they
contract.
They all will. Yeah. They all will. Everybody will be okay. Like, to make it to the show is an accomplishment as
in itself. Yeah.
So they will be fine. And this show, it is a stepping stone to some unbelievable things. Mm-hmm. And I do feel like he will be okay.
Explain to me very quickly the criteria to get on the show, though, because I feel like in recent seasons, and this happens on other shows, I've noticed this on American Idol and some other mm-hmm. competition shows, that a lot of these dancers are already dancers.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Like Brandon's on Step Up Revolution, yes. And he's on So Think. How's that happen?
How's it not a conflict?
Like he's
well,
already
the
he's
dance
already...
the dance world, you guys, it's so small.
Mm-hmm.
It is so small. So honestly, it just happens, you know, mm-hmm. and dancers want to get it started.
Yeah.
You know, so you have to be 18 to audition and the oldest you could be is 30, and that's basically a dancer's career right there. You
and
know
you're
what
done.
Me? And yeah, so I mean, you move on to bigger right. and better things, but I don't know. It just happens. The show, the dance world's very small.
So is there anything that would make you ineligible to even be on the show as far as, like, your previous dancing or can you have toured with Lady Gaga and then go beyond So You Think You Can Dance?
Absolutely.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe is it your contract? Because
I think it's better if you're already in a contract, something like how Alex Wong was the first time.
Yes.
Exactly.
He was already in a contract. So that could very well mm-hmm. make you ineligible.
But then he let it expire and then came
yes,
back.
Yes, and then came back. But I feel like it's an amazing opportunity for dancers who are, you know, green. Like I came straight from Star Power Dance Competition, you
yes,
know,
you did.
To audition. Like I was like a little, I was young and you get to work with these choreographers that like, oh my gosh, that people work their whole lives mm-hmm. to just try to work with, you know, their whole career to just mm-hmm. try to work with. And all of a sudden they have no choice but to work with you and you have no choice but to work with them. Mm-hmm. So you need to just do the best that you can, you know, but the dance world is extremely small. And after so many seasons, you know, it's just kind of what happens. And this show has really inspired people to be dancers, to go out there, to go get it. And so that's why I think it's kind of inevitable.
Speaking of choreographers, I've always been curious and I don't know the answer. And maybe you do. Whatever mm-hmm. happened to Wade Robson?
Yes. Wade Robson. I'm not really sure. I know he was doing I'm pretty sure he was doing Cirque or the Criss Angel show.
Okay.
Oh. I'm not sure, but he had a child.
Yeah.
I worked with him on my season. He was brilliant.
Yeah, the first few seasons he was
brilliant.
Very much a part of the show.
He was all about the show.
I'm not really sure.
He got a little bit hippie or something. He got a little bit earthier, a little bit something spiritual. Something started to change a little bit. I remember the last time I saw him on the show. I'm not saying that has anything to do with it. I'm just curious what happened if he could ever come back or if he would make a guest appearance or if he could choreograph for them again.
I don't know. I don't know. I think it's cool when choreographers reinvent themselves.
Yeah.
I think it's pretty cool because mm-hmm. I think sometimes they even get tired of the stuff that they're doing. You know, it's like anything. But I don't really know what he's up to. But he has always been brilliant in my eyes. You know,
mm-hmm.
so I hope
except
he comes
for when
back.
He stole Britney from Justin, and sent her to a 10-year downward spiral.
Oh,
she's never been the same.
Who was
I blame
your favorite?
You, Wade Robson.
Who was your favorite choreographer
to work with?
To work with?
Yeah. Oh my gosh, I loved working with Sonia.
Oh,
I love
her. She is so crazy. I would love her.
She is incredible. She comes in the room and she just has the most positive, amazing energy that, like, even if you feel broken in 1.5 million pieces, you're just like, okay, let's do it again.
Really?
Yeah.
I never would have guessed that.
Oh my gosh.
You gotcha.
Her energy.
I thought she was just really tough.
No. Well, she's tough,
yeah.
But her energy in the room is unbelievable. I loved working with Doriana Sanchez.
Oh.
Oh, she is one
I
of.
I can't.
She
I can't.
Is one of my she is one of the most special, amazing human beings on the planet.
I met her in the bathroom at the Kodak Theaters, and I was like, I know you. She was like, really? I was like, no, I just saw you on the show. she was really nice, though.
She's amazing.
She is kind of a rare gem, I will say, because there aren't many people who can choreograph.
Let me tell you something. Just she go is like a her. Gem.
Yeah.
She is a gem.
There are a lot of everybody wants to be a contemporary choreographer or a hip-hop choreographer and stuff nowadays, but there aren't a whole lot of people who are coming up nowadays, kids trying to choreograph.
She was in the original Dirty Dancing.
Crazy.
She's so nice.
The one girl tonight was a big fan of hers. Who's the dancer?
Wasn't it Audrey?
She's like, my favorite moment. I'm like,
really? I was like, I didn't like that routine.
Season one disco.
I don't think people underestimate Disco Man. I mean,
it's hard. It looks hard as can be.
It is so hard.
I don't like the outfits. Maybe that's just what
it's like. 70s Saturday Night Fever, you know?
Mm-hmm. It just reminds me of my mom.
Lots of sequins and polyester.
I love Tony and Melanie. Working with them for ballroom and Jean-Marc.
Was Stacey Tukey there when you were there? Was she there
yet?
She
was not. She was there, I want to say her first, I think seven? Her first piece, no, I think her first piece was six with Catherine and Legacy.
Oh, yeah. I love Stacey Tukey.
Oh, my gosh. Isn't she fantastic? Incredible. And she's another one who's as nice as they come.
She seems like it.
She is. Like Canadian. Nice. All Canadians.
Canadians are all nice. Yeah. Hey. So we've got two performances left. This next one is probably arguably the most iconic number of all time once you think you can dance. It's the bench piece.
Oh, God.
I mean, that was originally done by Heidi and Travis.
Oh.
Travis, arguably the best male to ever dance on the show.
Fantastic.
I mean, he's just great. And he's now a phenomenal choreographer.
Mm-hmm. With
and
his own reality TV show
he's
on
everywhere.
Oxygen.
He's everything. And Heidi, I think this number for Heidi was like her coming out party.
Yeah. It was.
It launched her into those last couple episodes of the season. She really just finally, she just stood out. She was no longer Benji's cousin anymore, right? She was Benji's cousin, correct?
Yeah.
She wasn't Benji's cousin anymore. She was Heidi now. And it became Heidi and Travis and the bench number. And that will always be the case. I thought, though, that Keon and Whitney tonight did a great job with it.
I think they did it justice.
Absolutely.
I was, like, not exactly the biggest fan in the beginning of this format.
I was resisting this, especially this number.
I was resisting it, too. And I really feel like they were fantastic.
Yes. He was. And normally my eyes always go to Whitney, but this time I was like,
he was like,
I couldn't even concentrate on her, and I was like, Whitney, I'm trying to catch
Corrine,
you.
Corrine, can I just say, I hope to God that the camera was on your eyebrow when you just did that damn thing, because your eyebrow went up and down three times. I don't know how you did that. I get it though. I wrote down Keon, amazing.
Yeah,
with a bunch of exclamation
points. Fantastic. And when Whitney ran off that bench and just snatched, oh my God.
And when he dragged her from under the bench, that moment, I'm like, they better nail that. And
so
they did.
It was so intense. It was so fantastic. Good.
I thought it was a little odd. Again, Nigel was on a tear tonight when he went into, in great detail, explaining that this story was about a gay man that Mia Michaels had loved years ago, and how she couldn't fully give her love to him, and he couldn't accept it because it would break her heart.
All her business in the
streets. And I was just like, I hope they had a conversation about that before they went live or went on the air, because
say that, though, season two?
I don't remember ever hearing that story. And I've watched every episode.
I don't remember.
But it didn't look like Mia cared, because she was like, I have my disguise on.
And
this whack wig.
My highlighted hair. Mia. We love you, Mia. But come on. No, I thought that number was great. I thought it was definitely
Keon.
For me, I think it was probably my favorite number of the night. I think Mary Murphy liked the next one, though, a little bit better. She loved this.
I know I did.
The drug, the addiction number.
Cole.
Cole's crazy.
Are you kidding me? He was so
intense,
sadistic, and and exactly what Nigel said, destructive, and it was almost like he, at certain points, if you looked, he didn't even look at her. Like, he was just like this dead stare.
He just controlled her.
Exactly.
He was the methamphetamine.
He completely.
He lost heat of meth.
Yeah. He was the crack cocaine.
He was exactly what he was supposed to be.
Yeah.
Exactly what he was. He was creepy.
But what did you think about Lindsay in the performance?
He carried her.
He
carries her every time.
But I feel like that's the thing,
except for her solo.
Because I think that Cole is phenomenal. Yeah, her solo is great. I think Cole's phenomenal, I think, though, he was almost a little too much. And that makes him not a great partner. Because I remember when Kayla and Capono did this originally. I think they both were they equally stood out. And I remember Kayla a lot more from that number even. Mm-hmm. And I feel like she really got overshadowed by Cole. Like, he was almost a little bit too sadistic, where it didn't allow her to really come out. I don't know if that was him or if that was her.
No.
Maybe she didn't rise to the occasion.
But then what do you want him to do? Do you want him to...
I feel like...
To pull back because she's not pulling up her weight? Are her stars and shining as
bright
as his? I
don't know, because I don't feel like he ever really paid any attention to her other than grabbing her and dragging her places.
I definitely disagree. And I think even from past episodes, I think he... really was a great partner. He was like all man.
Absolutely. You know what I mean? When he dances. I'm speaking of this number alone, but standalone. Within, I felt like, okay. I don't know. I thought he was great. I thought he was creepy.
No.
But I could have watched that number though without her.
But here's the completely. Thing for me. Within this number, and a lot of times with the partnering, you know, with the males partnering with the females, the women are always in the front. So my eye, like, he was in the back a lot during this number, and I'm just like,
plus he was dragging her ass all over the stage.
But maybe that's what the piece was. She's supposed to be like this, like, impressionable, vulnerable.
Yeah, there you go. She's supposed to be, but the eye should be going to her. But he was, to me,
I mean, Lindsay and Kayla are definitely different. They're definitely different dancers. They're different style dancers. Yeah. Yes. They're different dancers, but.
Oh. He's great. He's unique.
Love him.
Yeah. And he can back it up.
He's really, yeah.
So that brought us to the end of the episode, where now we find out, well, apparently we found this out at the beginning of the episode and I just wasn't paying attention.
He was asleep or something.
But they're eliminating two guys and two girls in the same episode. So the bottom three ladies turn out to be Amelia, Janelle, and Lindsay. I thought that Amelia's solo was boring, uninspired. I thought Janelle was sexy.
Hot.
But she was just doing her belly thing again, belly dancing thing. It was cool, but we've seen it. Lindsay, I just wrote down insane. Because Lindsay was the one going into that. I assumed she was the one who'd probably go.
I knew she was going to go.
But she killed it. She was
powerful.
Yes, she legitimately saved herself in that number. I feel like maybe they didn't know for sure who they were getting rid of going into that. And I feel like if they didn't, she definitely saved herself because she was great.
Oh, her legs are sick.
And it's so hard. I feel like it's got to be so hard to do a ballroom solo.
Yeah, that's by tricky. Yourself.
Yeah, and I thought she was great.
Not for her.
Amelia and Janelle were two of the more interesting characters of the season. But I feel like this season, different in years past, they're not sticking with characters so much. They got rid of Amber. They got rid of Amelia and Janelle. They're getting rid of the unique ones, and they're going with the better dancers right now, which is interesting because that doesn't always happen. Some seasons you get to the finale and it's a bunch of just weirdos, which is great and interesting, but a lot of the dancers get lost along the way.
But Amber wasn't unique to me. She wasn't a character.
She was the only sister on the show. I'm saying aesthetically, the people who stand out, that look differently. They've got a few blondes left. They've got a few brunettes left. Usually get rid of the duplicates early.
I think the best part about this season is that they have both. Mm-hmm. They have personality that makes you want to watch the show. Mm-hmm. And then they live up to their personality with their dancing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nice. They can back it up.
And that's what I enjoyed very much so.
I hope Cyrus starts backing it up because I really enjoy him and I feel like he needs to show some growth. They had 2 weeks off. He's not bad. I just really want him to surprise me because I love nothing more, and America loves nothing more than being surprised by somebody. Right. All of a sudden they come out of their shell and they just nail it. And like that's why Twitch was so great. Nobody expected him to be that good.
Right. But Twitch also grew.
But he did.
That's the best part about the show. I love that I could watch a person. Honestly, when you just watch every weekend, they're just amazing, amazing, amazing. They lift their leg above their head. I get it. Yeah. I get it. You could do it. But to me, when I watch somebody who's kind of like the underdog and then they kind of like
that's why it's called America's favorite dancer.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I don't see that in Cyrus, though.
I don't see it yet.
I just see him doing this the whole time.
See, I see heart in Cyrus.
I'll give him that.
I see the heart, but not the growth.
I saw heart through the auditions. Since he's been on the show, I just feel like he really hasn't changed at all, and he really hasn't evolved yet. And I hope it happens, because he's my favorite guy on the show.
I think he's doing what he's asked to do.
Mm. But I think
I think it's really hard. Like, so, okay, season 7, I partnered with Jose. Mm-hmm. And Jose, we did a Broadway routine, and he was doing a double tour to the ground. But they commented on how we just don't feel like, you know, it was good enough, or we just don't feel that boy has never done a freaking tour in his life.
Right.
That's true.
Like, so, and then, and so it. As the all-star, like, I totally knew, like, what he was feeling, because yeah. he's not, maybe, you know, Jose wasn't, he's not a hip-hop, he's a b-boy.
Yeah.
There's a difference. Mm-hmm. And so that's also another thing that America may not realize. Mm-hmm. Cyrus, he's a freestyler. Mm-hmm. That boy does not do choreography.
At all.
And so now he's on that, now he's on a show where all he's doing is choreography. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I see passion, and I do see heart.
Well, he wasn't even in the bottom three, so I guess America does.
We love him.
We all love him. Yeah. I just want to see continued growth.
He's not good enough
to win the show yet. He's just not.
Stop shaking.
But if he can continue to get better, though, and I hope he does, I think he's got a great shot at it. As of tonight, though, our bottom three is George, Darian, and Matthew.
Yes.
They ended up, well, let's just say this real quick. I think that Darian had some insane turns. I thought he was a little bit off-centered, whatever that means. Mm-hmm. He kind of traveled a little bit.
On his alicycums.
Yeah, I guess that's what it would be called. Alicycums. I think of it as, in terms of figure skating, you can't travel across the ice. You have to stay. he traveled. I don't know if it's called the same
on
thing.
On his alicycums.
Yes. And then Matthew bored the living daylights out of me. I thought he was so, I wrote down sleepy time.
Second.
So boring.
I second
And
that.
He's so great. I'm like, yeah. Exactly. Thanks, I thought man. I was going to fall asleep. George, to me, I think he's forgettable, but his dancing is so powerful and so beautiful.
Amazing. I just wrote amazing. Exclamation.
I think George's dancing is just, it was powerful. Mm-hmm. It showed strength. It showed technique. Darian, to me, he really did look like he was fighting for his life.
He had heart.
Yeah. Like he was dancing for his life. He put his heart
right there. And he had some teary eyes when they let him go. Poor guy.
I know.
And to be that close to the tour, it's gotta hurt.
And it was such a good song.
Oh my God,
song that he chose to dance to.
Yeah, that's a man's the other world. Thing. Yes. That's the other thing, is that the song, it just can't be boring. Mm. You can't pick a boring song. You have to pick a song that, like, shows dancing for your life is
exactly
it's
that.
It's very serious. Desperate. Yeah, mm-hmm. Like it is
serious.
So you wanna show that. It's kind of like
I'd be dancing to Jennifer Holiday every week.
Okay. Everything you got.
I'm telling you. I'm going. Oh. But he danced to, let's give a little shout out to Joshua Ledet, though.
Joshua, I voted for you on Idol.
Huge fan of Joshua Ledet. And he picked a great song, Darian did.
Because he killed that song.
Didn't work for him tonight. Aww. But we're down to our top 10 now.
Yes.
We've got our group that's going on tour heading into episode 11, which is exciting. This is when things really start to get intense and start to heat up.
They get real.
I'm really excited about the rest of the season. Real quick, though, you have a couple of things I would like to talk about really quickly.
Yes.
Now, you revealed not that long ago that you were diagnosed with MS.
Yes.
And that has now become, for you and your brother, I believe,
yes.
Something that you guys are very passionate about. How are you involved and what are you doing to make a difference?
Well, I was diagnosed in February. And my brother and I, he's more of the business side of it. I'm more of the artistic side of it. We started our own dance convention called The Beat.
Uh-huh.
And the timing of all this was just really kind of insane. We have faculty like Twitch, Allison, myself, William, Robert, Ade.
Some of the greats,
man. Mommies. And we have Jeff Thacker, who I was talking about before, actually doing a mock audition and showing the dancers kind of, you know, what we went through, which I think is really cool, kind of showing them what they don't see on TV. But anyway, it's called The Beat. Mm-hmm. And me and my brother were like, let's start something called Beat MS. And I was diagnosed the day after our first event. And so a portion of every registration this year is going to our foundation, which we've teamed up with the MS Society.
Mm-hmm.
And so all the proceeds are going to the MS Society, which is an incredible organization. I've also had meetings with them. We are trying to organize a dance event. Right now we're working around the logistics, because I was like, there's just a walk and a bike ride. And I was like, you know what? This is a disease that stops you from moving. And this is my livelihood.
And as a dancer, I'm sure.
This is my livelihood. This is what I do. And so I want to help as much as I can to make sure that that does not happen.
Well, I think that's that's commendable, and that's so incredible. I've known people with MS, and it's a tough battle.
Yes, it is.
But you're still doing it. You're still dancing.
Yeah.
It's so fantastic, especially see younger people who are challenged with something like this, who, as opposed to letting it get them down. They're using it. They're turning it into a positive, and now you're gonna impact so many lives.
I hope so. At first, I was like, I didn't really want to reveal it because I was like,
you're a dancer.
I'm afraid that people are gonna think that I can't do things because this disease comes with the notion that it stops you from moving.
Well, you're gonna change that.
And that is my mission.
If people want to know more, if they want to know more about the organization, how can they get your information?
They could go to www.thebeatdance.com, and on our website, we also have a link to the National MS Society. Yes. And I think. You know, my mom gets really upset sometimes when people see her and they're like, oh my gosh, how's Courtney? Can she walk? Mm-hmm. Is she? And my mom, and I'm like, you can't get up. They're not ignorant. They're just uneducated. Mm-hmm. They're not educated. Mm-hmm. They're not educated on what this is. And not many people are because it's not many people want to talk about it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I was talking to somebody last week that their dad was a firefighter, and after being 20 years as a firefighter, they found out he had MS and they fired him. Sure. And so that's what it comes with. But to me, you know what? If that's what you think,
right?
If that's the thing then I don't want to be surrounded by you anyway.
Right.
That is ignorance.
Well, good for
you. And so getting involved, I think, gives me power in a powerless situation.
Yeah.
And I'm going to use whatever platform I've been given to try and help.
And you're doing it.
Thanks.
And you're going to be trying. Marie Osborne.
Marie Osmond tomorrow. Yeah. I'm really excited about it. The episode airs in October, and I'm actually getting to dance with Marco from season 8.
Yay. Really?
Yeah. So I'm really, really excited.
You've got some exciting stuff coming up.
I know.
Nice. Do you have a website? Fancy. I believe you do have a website.
I have, well, on my dance convention website, thebeatdance.com. Okay. We're going to Orlando, Dallas,
so
New York,
okay.
And Atlanta. And yeah, that's where we, you know, everybody's Twitter is linked up there. So you can follow all of us. You can follow all the faculty and just kind of see what they're up to. And also our Facebook page, facebook.com/thebeatdance. We have everybody's updates. We have, you know, when Allison does things on TV or Twitch or Dominic. Nice.
I love seeing it. Way in the hosting community as it is in the dance community. I'm sure it's great to see each other succeed.
Oh my gosh.
And you have to help each other out, especially in this city.
Yep.
We have to look out for each other, and that's great. And the organization sounds fantastic. I'm going to check the website out.
Thank you very
much. As
soon
as I get home. Thank you guys, check out thebeat.com.
Thebeatdance.com.
Thebeatdance. Oh, God. There it is. Thebeatdance. Thebeat.com is probably a completely different website.
I'm afraid of what that is.
Yeah, thebeatdance.com. We want to thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you for having me.
I
want to
skip right over predictions because I don't think, what are we going to predict?
Nothing.
I think things are going to get heated next week.
Two people are going to go home next week.
But I want to give
it's anybody's game, man.
It is anybody's game. I will. That is
AJ,
very true.
You going to get ever, like, we have a dance area. You have so many dancers. Oh, are we ever going to get the dancers to dance?
Are we
going to
get Courtney to dance right now?
Oh, my God.
Bump,
can we do it? Do we have some music, Philip?
Bump, bump.
Well, what do you want?
Bump.
I can get something going. So you think your dance theme song?
Only if you...
No.
Corrine will dance with you. Over here. No, we got... Oh, right over here. Right over here.
In my movie?
Yes.
Wait, do I really have to dance?
Yeah.
Just pop my shoulder.
Yeah. You can do it. Yes.
You're amazing.
And can I tell you how fierce you look in those heels?
Those are Christian lubes, everybody.
Yeah, they are. Look
the
at that.
Real red bottoms. Red get your bottom. Life.
Oh, Lord.
She's rich.
Well, we're
I'm saving my money to buy me one pair.
Poor,
right?
That's not like, two. That's shoes. One shoe. Me, that's like the right foot.
Me too, just
poor
so I can put them on display.
Poor with great shoes.
Well, there you go. This, that's the only way to go. Yeah, perfect 10 in my book. Thank you so much for being here. We are going to have some of your friends in the studio the next few weeks. We are more than welcome to come back anytime you
like. I would love to come back.
You are a doll.
It's so much fun.
And where can our listeners find you on Twitter?
At Courtney Galiano, CourtneyGaliano.
And you, Corrine.
So cute. At Just Saying 08, that's JustSaying08. Get your life.
That would be your Twitter. And you guys can follow me on Twitter at _AJ Gibson. Please check out my new website also at www.ajgibson.tv. Thank you guys for stopping by. We'll be back in the studio next week for another episode of So You Think You Can Dance. Take care.
Holla.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.